This is a classic example of a simple Bayesian network model called the Asia model. The objective of the model is to determine the most likely diagnosis for a patient entering a chest clinic. The nodes here represent variables which may or may not be known, and for simplicity, all of these nodes are Boolean, meaning they have just two states, which were taken to be yes or no in this case. There's a directed edge between two nodes if there is a causal or influential relationship between those nodes. For example, a person who is a smoker is more likely to have lung cancer than a person who is a non-smoker. Similarly with bronchitis. And a person who has any of these conditions is more likely to have the symptom of dyspnea, which is shortness of breath. Now, associated with every node is a probability table. So, for example, for the node smoker, the probability table is just 50-50 for yes or no, because that represents the fact that 50% of the people who enter the chest clinic are smokers. Whereas for visit to Asia, only 1% of the people have had a recent visit to Asia. For nodes which have parents, the probability table is a conditional probability table. So we have to give the probabilities conditioned on the states of the parent nodes. So if a person is a smoker, there's a 10% chance that this person will have been diagnosed with lung cancer. And if the person is a non-smoker, there's only a 1% chance they would have been diagnosed with lung cancer. Now, in its prior or so-called marginal state, the probabilities here represent just what is known about the population of people entering the chest clinic. But of course, we want to use the model for individualized risk assessment. So suppose a patient comes in and is a non-smoker. So we're going to enter that observation. And now what's going to happen is we're going to run the model, and it's going to do all of the Bayesian inference. And in particular, look at how the probabilities of these nodes change. So a non-smoker, probability of lung cancer went down, probability of bronchitis went down. Similarly, these all went down. At this point, if that's all you know about this person, then it's unlikely that they've got any of these conditions, because the highest probability here is 30% for bronchitis. But suppose they report shortness of breath. When we run the model again, see what happens. These two increase by a little bit, but they're still quite low. But bronchitis is now over 75%. So you would diagnose bronchitis as a likely condition in this case. Well, suppose we send the patient for an x-ray and it comes back positive. Run the model again. TB and lung cancer have gone up quite a bit now, but they're still way below bronchitis, which is still the likely diagnosis at this point. However, suppose we decide to check if this person had a recent visit to Asia, and it turns out they did. In this case, when we run the model, everything changes. Tuberculosis, almost from nowhere, now becomes the most likely probable diagnosis.